Both the English versus American Lab are paid up members of the Labrador Retriever breed, but they've become established as different types. English Labradors tend to be stockier, whilst American Labs are more slender with a finer coat. But how do you know which one better suits to you? Divided into 8 topics, you will learn everything about the differences of these two dog breeds in this video. Let us know which breed you prefer after you've watched the video. Number 1. Origin. The Labrador Retriever originated in Newfoundland, Canada, where their ancestors, the St. John's dog, worked alongside fishermen in icy waters and harsh conditions. Essentially, there was only one type of lab until the 1940s, when exhibiting dogs became popular. Over the next few decades, 2 different strains of the dog emerged due to specialized breeding. One type was bred for the show ring, where appearance matters. These dogs were not required to work, and embellishments in their conformation began to emerge. They became known as English Labs. At the same time, working type lab dogs began flourishing in competitions known as field trials, where speed and agility were the most desirable qualities. These are now what we know as American Labs. Number 2. Personality. Regardless of type, when it comes to being loving, affectionate, and an immense desire to please, both the American and English Labradors are equally matched. True to the breed standard, and part of what makes a lab, both the American and English types are highly intelligent, keen, and biddable. The reason for the difference between the English Lab versus American Lab is due to many decades of specialized breeding. Labradors, bred especially to hunt and compete in field trials, are selectively bred for their working abilities, higher energy, higher drive, more athletic, slimmer built, and agile dogs. These are the most desirable traits in a working Labrador. Labradors bred for show in conformation competitions are selectively bred for their looks and temperament alone, with the Labs most closely matching the breed standard, and winning awards in the ring going on to be used in breeding programs. In the past, many breeders were aiming for the prestigious double champion, who would win in both shows and out in the field, but the two disciplines have become so specialized and competitive, so breeders have to concentrate on just the one area to stand any hope of success. Number 3. Appearance. The English Labrador is bred purely for show purposes. As such, they're bred to conform to Labrador standards as close as possible. They have a stockier frame compared to their American cousin, with deep barrel chests and shorter legs. Surprisingly, they have thicker fur and a thicker otter tail than the working Americans. The American Labrador tends to be slightly taller and slender in appearance. He's more muscular and less chunky. He has a thinner coat, with a longer neck and longer muzzle, both of which contribute to his working abilities. They can grow up to 24.5 inches tall, which is 62 centimeters, and weigh up to 80 pounds, which is 36 kilograms. Number 4. Trainability. Labradors in general react well to training because they are smart and eager to please. In addition to basic obedience and socialization, these dogs benefit from agility, tracking, and other training that benefits both mind and body. Some people say English Labs are easier to train, but that may be because they often don't require as much training as American Labs. English Labs can display some level of distractibility as puppies that make them more difficult in that regard. American Labs are more finicky, but they're also extremely focused and responsive. It's absolutely vital that you train and socialize both types of lab. If you want to learn more about dog brain training and training methods, check out the description. Number 5. Time investment. American Labradors are very active and will need lots of mental and physical stimulation. This breed's favorite activities are retrieving and swimming, but he'll also enjoy playing games that involve spending time with their beloved people. If you like a higher level of activity or hunting games, the American Labrador is best for you. However, if you want a lab that doesn't require too much activity, an English Labrador is the most suitable. Number 6. Best home. While both the English and the American Labs make excellent companions, picking the proper disposition is entirely dependent on your lifestyle. If you have young children who love to romp and play, or you are a person who frequently exercises, the American Lab may be the best. They'll keep up with active routines and will thrive in fast-paced environments. If you're looking for a calmer, more even-keeled dog, opting for the English version may be your best choice. They will be cuddlier and less spastic. While they may be slightly less of a handful, they might not catch on quite as quickly as their American cousins to commands. Number 7. Health. While both dogs have similar health concerns, certain conditions may be more prevalent on one side or the other. They mutually have joint issues, heart issues, and potential genetic defects. They are both at risk for hip dysplasia. But because American Labs perform retrieving and other high-endurance activities, they are more likely to develop this condition. They also have a likelier probability of having other joint-related disorders like patellar luxation and osteochondritis dissecans. Each of them shares the same lifespan, ranging between 10 to 12 years. Number 8. Costs. The English and the American Labrador cost, on average, upwards of $1,200 from a reputable breeder. Expect to pay a premium if you're purchasing a bench lab that you plan to use for shows. If you would like a pup who is from a winning bloodline, be that a working bloodline or a bench bloodline, then you can expect to pay a little more, upwards of $2,000. Generally, however, there is not a significant difference in the price between the field and the bench Labrador. It truly depends on the breeding lines. Regardless if you are looking at a field or bench lab, just realize that it's the same breed. One type of lab has slightly different energy levels than the other. They're both built slightly different, but they are the same dog. So what do you think? Do you prefer the American or English Labrador? Let us know in the comments and share your experience. And if you found this video helpful, it would be great if you subscribe to our channel so you don't miss new videos and you learn more about dogs every day. Also, check out our other dog comparisons. Thank you so much for watching.